Hello everyone, this is Dr. Abhinav, and in this video today we'll see about the UPSC CMS Indian Railway Health Service cadre. So I'll be talking about the pros and cons of this cadre. So how much is the salary? So will this cadre suit you, or which cadre should you choose, and all those kind of things. And also I'll be talking about the PG, the DNB seats that are allotted in the railway services also. So let's go into the video. So if you see here, these are the questions that I'll be answering today. So if you want to know the answers of these 7 questions, stay and watch this video completely. So regarding the first question, why to choose Indian Railway Health Service? So the Railway Health Service is one of the most respected departments. Plus the lifestyle of this service is really good. The work-life balance and all those things are really good. Plus the salary is good, and you'll have more and more benefits compared to other cadres also. So this is why this is a very, very, very good cadre to choose. So the next thing is, what type of work is it? So if you see the work, basically you will be dealing with the outpatients, the inpatients, the station emergencies. So whenever you are being called to the station, railway station, because there is some emergency, to one of the passengers who has been traveling in the train, you'll have to go and attend those patients. Plus, you will also do the pre-employment screening of patients and periodic medical examinations. So that will be like kind of checking color blindness to the railway pilot, if he's having any color blindness, or if there is any hernia or any appendix emergencies that could arise. All those things you'll be completely checking for employees who are about to join the department and the employees who are already in the department. So you'll be monitoring them, you'll be checking them. It's a really very good, very interesting, and a very respectable task. So if you see the hospitals in the railway, it starts from the health unit, then goes to the subdivisional, divisional hospitals, and then the central hospitals. So this is how the level of hospital increases. So if you see on your side, you will be starting as an assistant divisional medical officer, then you will be a divisional medical officer, then you will be a deputy, after that you will be a senior divisional medical officer, then you will be a deputy chief medical superintendent, and then you will become a chief medical superintendent, and then you will become the chief medical director. Then finally, the most important, the biggest thing in the railway is director general. So as the level of the hospital increases, and if you compare it with your level of your position in the railways, as you get promotions more and more, you will be shifted to higher centers as well. So if you are being a deputy chief medical superintendent, there are more chances that you will be in the district hospitals or in the central institute also. So this is how it goes. You see, for the promotions, in the railways, the promotion is quite a bit slow. So you'll be promoted every 4 to 5 years. And then, so if it is 4 to 5 years, so with the promotions, your salary will also be increasing little by little. So if you see the salaries for, that's not CGHS, sorry. So if you see the salary for Indian Railway Health Service, so starting you will get around 80 to 1 lakh. So every year there will be little by little increments, and once you get promoted, there will be increments also. So the working hours, basically the working hours will be from 9 to 5, but if there are any emergencies or any station emergency calls, you will have to go and attend whatever the time may be. So apart from that, there are not many patients, so the work-life balance is really good in railways. So can I do PG after joining IRHS? Why not? So after 2 years of service, you will be eligible for the sponsorship quota for the DNB in railway hospitals. So if you've seen the railway hospitals, 50% of DNB seats in the railway hospital are reserved for the railway employees. So if you are a IRHS officer and you have worked for 2 years, then after 2 years, you can give your NEET PG and you can get selected in the DNB quota for the railway hospitals. There are also options to be selected in the central institute such as AIIMS also. So for that, you will be having to work a little longer, and you will have your sponsorship quotas there as well. So that's regarding the working hours. So can I do PG after joining IRHS? Yes, I've seen that. You've seen that already. So benefits of being an IRHS doc. So benefits, if you see, there are actually a lot and lots of benefits. So initially you'll get a bungalow to stay, and then not a bungalow, but after promotions you'll get a bungalow. So initially you'll get a good place to stay. So then after that you will have free passes, six free passes per year. All those are first class tickets. So as you get promoted, you will also have free flight tickets. And apart from this, you will be getting your children's tuition fee, that is nearly 27 to 30,000. And then medical benefit treatments, all your treatments will be covered under the railways. Plus, with all these, you will be also having houses, separate houses, like guest houses, where you can go and stay there. You can also have, there will be like swimming pools, pool tables, and all those things. You can use those facilities. And every month there will be like parties or family gatherings, traditional gatherings, and all those things, which is a really nice thing to have. So all these are benefits of being an IRHS doctor. But what are the cons of being an IRHS doctor? Is that you're a PG, your salary and the MBBS salary will not be very different. So the salary gap between an MBBS doctor and a PG doctor in IRHS is not very great. And you're being a PG, and so your promotion here in IRHS will also be quite soon. And then if you see, you're an IRHS doctor, you will be having to stay in the headquarters for you will be having to stay in the headquarters every time, because in the 24 hours, anytime you may be called for the station emergencies. So if you have to leave the headquarters, you will have to inform and get permissions for those things. So apart from all those things, you see the railway cadres is really a very good cadre to choose. And if you're interested in choosing the railway cadres, so please comment in the comment section. So that's all for this IRHS cadre. If you have any doubt also, you can mention it in the comment section. I'll try to clear it out. So yes, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you.